is that the resonating structures or contributors, we have two types of contributors. Okay, so write down next. Contributors or resonating structures. We have two types. One is equal contributor. Other one is unequal contributor. The equal contributor example we have. See, both molecules look like identical, right? This one, equal contributor. Even if you draw the benzene ring, this is also equal contributor. Benzene ring, okay? The stability of RS in case of equal contributor is generally more than the stability of unequal contributors, okay? Stability, we'll see that comparison, but okay, unequal contributor, the example is CH2 negative C double bond O H. It is a conjugated system.
So, sir, in benzene ring, can't you apply pi sigma pi?
You can.
Will it end up to be the same thing?
Yes, it should. Name drop. Okay, and when you shift this here, this becomes negative, this becomes positive. Double bond. Here we have positive, here you are negative. This negative comes over here, this pi electron goes here. Double bond.
Positive. What is the one in the middle? You have like positive and negative. Won't that be a separate resonance?
Which one? You're talking about this one.
Like
one positive charge, one
negative
charge. Yeah, that's right. This one. No, it is also not. See, this look like different structures, right? But the positive negative charge here is highly unstable. Okay, and when this comes over here, see, you can take it this way also. We don't draw like this, okay? We just continuously shift this electron pair like this. This comes over here, this comes over here, this comes over here, and we'll get this.
Oh, so we just skip that?
Yeah, so we don't write this actually in between, okay? So it converts into this, and these two are the resonating structures. So when you draw the hybrid of it, you'll draw the entire molecule.
So, benzene has only two resonating structures.
No, if they ask you how many RS possible for benzene ring, so we'll contribute, we'll count all these structures. But this two structure, if you're talking about, I'm talking about this two structure. This to the contribution of this and this is same in the real structure. So this two are equal contributing structures. Okay? This one, the stability is lesser than this one. Even any charge species is lesser stable than these two structures, right? So their stability is more. But if you talk about the stability of these two, it is same and its contribution is also same.
So which type is that?
This one. Yeah. Oh, here it will be pi sigma lone pair or pi sigma of any type you will consider.
So we can start at one type of conjugation and then end up with different conjugation.
Yes. In between you can have any kind of conjugation. If it is conjugation, shifting of electrons is possible. Understood this? Now this molecule you see, this comes over here. CH2, double bond CO minus CH3. It is unequal contributor. Okay, the contribution is not same. Even if you take this example, double bond O, this part is not involved in resonance. This part is not involved in resonance. अरे कॉन्जुगेशन नहीं है सिंपली इफ यू से व्हाई 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 नो द दिस साइड द राइट साइड ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल इज नॉट इन्वॉल्वड दैट्स
व्हाई द फर्स्ट वन व्हाई इज इट
फर्स्ट वन दिस पार्ट इज नॉट इन्वॉल्वड इज नॉट वी हैव कॉन्जुगेशन ओनली हियर नॉट दिस पार्ट सो इट इज अनइक्वल कॉन्जुगेशन When contribute when the resonance is there in the entire molecule.
So, but even there, the H bond wasn't it? H is associated with. It's not the parent chain.
Parent chain is this only. Parent chain is this. Got it? Now, one thing you see, like in equal contributor structures, the stability is same, exactly same, and hence the contribution is also same. Right? But here, since the stability is different. So contribution is also different, and that's why it is unequal contributors. So in this case, we can talk about major contributors and major and minor contributors. Major contributors is that structure which is the most stable structure among the resonating structure that you are drawing. Okay, and it contributes maximum into the real structure. Okay, minor contributors whose stability is less. Okay, and here major and minor is not possible because all RS has the same stability, right? So all are equal contributors.
So, but in that one,
no, no, no. I'm talking this. I'm, if you draw this, it's fine. But these two are equal contributors. Okay, well, we'll have that. We'll have 6-7 different rules to find out the stability that we'll do now. Okay, so next, write down. See, like I said here, the one of the structure is major contributors and other one is minor contributors. Correct? So, which one is major or minor that depends upon the stability of the RS. Okay, so to find out the stability of RS, we have 6 or 7 different rules, 8 different rules we have. Okay, so according to that rule, we'll find out the stability of RS. And this is the stability of RS comparison of the same molecules or ions. We cannot compare the RS of this and this. Same molecule to RS we are comparing, right? So write down the, next, the factors affecting relative stability of RS, resonating structure. Factors affecting the relative stability of RS. Okay? So we'll follow, compare the relative stability of RS in the same manner. Like first we have to apply rule 1, then rule 2 and rule 3 like this we have. Okay? So rule 1 in this you write down. Rule 1 you write down, the structure which has more number of pi bond is more stable. The structure which has more number of pi bond is more stable. Okay, so first example in this, suppose the molecule is this. Okay. Can you draw the RS in this? Correct. Okay. Can you draw RS in this one? Suppose this is A and this is B. Which one is more stable, A or B?
A.
Because it has more number of pi. So stability of A is more than that of B. Okay. What is the RS for this one? This comes over here. Okay, second one has more number of pi bonds, so B is more stable than Okay? Just you have to follow the rules in this. First rule, if fails, then we use the second rule, third rule, and so on. Okay? Now, the property of this is what? Suppose you have to draw the RS of this two molecules. Okay? So, the RS kya hoga? Will have a structure like this. Single bond O. And this pi bond is delocalized from this carbon to this oxygen to this carbon. Right? So, we'll have a pi bond characteristics here. Like this. Okay? Pi bond characteristics here. Now, which one is more stable here? A is more stable. So, if the question is the bond order of this C1, C2 carbon, if you want to compare, the bond order of C1, C2 carbon. So, we can definitely say that the bond order of C1, C2 carbon is closer to 2 since this is more stable. So this contributes more into the real structure. Right? So, it is closer to 2 and we can say the bond order of C1, C2 carbon lies in this range. This we can say. And if they ask the question for equal contributors, remember we cannot find out the exact value of bond order. We can give this range. Okay, then our option also will be in range only. Whether it is closer to 1 or closer to 2. Got it? First of all, the bond order here is what? 1? Here it is 2. So it lies in this range 1 to 2. And since this one is more stable, which has bond order 2, right? So we can say that bond order is closer to 2. It must be more than 1.5 but less than 2. Because if both are equal, then bond order is what? 1.5, average of the two. Right? So since it is not equal, so this is more stable, so closer to 2. Yes, we can see. Understood this? Rule number 2 you write down. And remember always, from these rules, we'll compare the relative stability of RS of a given molecule or ion. We cannot compare the RS of the two different molecules. C is this, C1, C2 bond order. C1, C2 bond order, carbon 1, 2. Okay? We'll do this bond order part also later on. Okay, I'm just giving you an idea. Rule number 2 you write down. When the number of pi bonds are equal, when the number of pi bonds are equal, then stability decreases with charge separation. And stability decreases with charge separation. Charge separation means when you have one molecule is charged, another one is neutral. So neutral one is more stable in the other way we can say. So for this the example is, you see this one. Benzene pair will have OH. Like this. And its RS is what? We have done this already, this comes over here and this comes over here. So its resonating structure is OH positive. This one. Another example if you see. NH2 nitrogen has one lone pair. It is also electron releasing. Okay, this electron pair comes over here, this pi electron shift onto this carbon. Now in these two examples, if you compare, how many pi bonds we have here? 3. How many pi bonds we have here? 3. So first rule we cannot compare, then we'll have a charge separation here in this, plus minus. Here it is, no charge, right? So this one is more stable. A is more stable than B. Got it? Similarly, in second one, again, A is more stable than B. There's no charge separation.
Wait, so by charge separation, you mean like presence of charge?
Yes, charge presence.
Because that in the next...
Overall, it is neutral.
Yeah, so in like the next resonating structure of that, the minus moves one more down.
Yes, yes, yes.
So both of those we cannot compare using the second.
With this rule we cannot compare. Okay. For that we have another. Okay? Next time, rule number 3.
Which is the actual physical distance between the charges doesn't matter.
That is also a factor. We'll see that. Another rules we have.
But that's not this
one. No. Like if you want to compare from rule 1 and rule 2, another RS if you draw. These two structure we cannot compare with rule 1 and 2. For that we have, okay?